So good morning, all of you.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am.
Completed the rules of all the tenses, all the 12 tense forms, and we started discussing about the usages, right? And we completed present tense. We completed. We started with the simple past, right?
Yes,
simple past is over. So today we are planning to discuss about the usages of the past continuous tense. Okay. So what do you mean by past continuous? I have told you, simple past is used to show a completed action at some time in the past. It has occurred in the past and also it is completed in the past. There is no effect with the present tense. Okay. And what is past continuous then at the same time? Can anybody tell me what is past continuous?
Continued and then stopped.
The past continuous denotes or it describes an action which was going on at some time in the past. Okay? Which was going on. The action was going on, the continuous ing forms. Okay? The action was going on some time in the past. Okay? No effect in the present. Simple past tense. I have told you it shows a completed action. It shows it is an action occurred or was completed in the past. To show a habitual action in the past also, we are using simple past tense. And we are using the phrase used to plus verb to show a habitual action in the past, isn't it? But past continuous is used to describe an action which was going on at some point of time, at some time in the past. Am I clear? She was reading a novel. She was reading a novel. Was reading. That action was going on then. It was going on then. It was going on. Okay, continuous action. Okay, in some time in the past. Am I clear?
Yes,
ma'am. Clear?
And to show two parallel actions happen in the past also, we are using, or happening in the past also, we are using others past continuous tense. What do you mean by two parallel actions? Parallel. Two actions, it was going on at the same time. Two actions were going on at the same time. Okay, I'll give you one example for two parallel actions used in past tense. Okay, the example is I was studying. Okay, I was studying when. Give me another part. I was studying
and
while
he was playing.
She was cooking dinner. Okay, I was studying while she was, see, look at here. I was studying. I was studying while she was cooking dinner. See, two parallel actions. Okay, same time. At the same time, two parallel actions. She was studying. At the same time, my mother was cooking dinner. Am I clear? Two actions,
yes.
But it is happening at the same time. So it is called a parallel action. Okay. Am I clear, kids? To show
yes,
such
ma'am.
Actions, we are using past continuous tense. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Am I clear? So past continuous is used to show some action, or it is describing an action which was going on at some particular time in the past. It can be a particular time, it can be a point of time, or it can be a period of time. I was reading my novel. Okay, I was reading Harry Potter. I was reading Harry Potter. Okay, was reading Harry Potter sometime or over a period of time in the past. And to show two parallel actions, I can use to show two parallel action happened in the past or happening at the same time in the past, I can use past continuous. Another example for the parallel action is while Ellen was watching TV, while Ellen was watching or while Ellen was reading, Tom
I was
watching TV.
Playing.
While Ellen was reading. What is the name I said?
Ellen.
Ellen was watching TV.
Ellen was reading. Ellen. Tim was watching TV.
TV.
Write any now. No problem. You can write your own. If you want to write Emelina, while Emelina was reading, Alisa was watching TV. Or YC was in the reverse.
Now she is watching TV.
Now she is watching. While Emelina was studying, Alisa was watching TV. So two parallel action. Now it is in present. At present time, this moment she is doing, right? But we are just talking about the past. Two actions happened at the same time. Two parallel action at the same time in the past. Okay?
Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. And okay, so past continuous, two usages we have learned today. Another usage, okay? We are using this past continuous to describe an action on a point of time. About that, I would like to share an example. The example is, at 6 a.m. This morning means today morning, right? At 6 a.m. this morning, I was doing my homework. Look at the example. At 6 a.m. It is actually pointing. It's just pointing a time. At 6 a.m. That particular time. This morning. Today morning. So what is the time now? The time is now 11:39. Okay. The time is now 11:39. So in the near past. At 6 a.m. this morning, I was doing my homework. Now the time is 11:40. Okay, now the time is 11:40. Understood? So we are using past continuous to show an action which was happening at some time, some point of time in the past. It was happening. It was going on. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Past continuous. If two actions happening, okay, just remember two actions happening in the past. Okay, two actions, if it is happening in the past, among these two actions, one action is actually happening at the moment of speaking. Out of this two actions are going on at the same time. One is completed, the other one is going on. In that case, to show an action in progress at that time, we are using past continuous tense. Let me repeat once again. Two actions happening at the same moment. Out of that, one is completed and one is still going on. To show such an action, we are using past continuous tense. I'll give you an example. The example is, they were sleeping when the thief entered the room. They were sleeping when the thief entered the room. See, two actions happened. It's already over in the past. It is in the past, two past actions, right? Out of these two past actions, one is completed and the other one is still going on. When the thief entered. Thief entered. Now, where is the thief? He is in the room, right? What is your mother doing?
Still sleeping.
What is and Amal Antony is doing? Still, the thief is there at your home in the room. Okay, and what Amal Antony doing? He was sleeping there. Okay, he was sleeping there then in the past. Okay, then in the past. So two actions. One is over, means it's just happened, occurred. Thief entered. That time Amal Antony was sleeping. He was sleeping. So understood. So out of these two actions, we are using one to show an action in progress at that time. We are using past continuous tense. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, two actions are already over. Okay. Two actions are already over. And out of these two actions, one action took place earlier than the other one. So which tense we should use here?
Time.
Two actions happened in the past. Okay, easy to remember. Two actions happened in the past. Both the actions are over. Both the actions are completed. But the problem, one action happened before the other one.
Past perfect.
Past perfect.
Correct. Past perfect. Absolutely, you are correct. We have to use past perfect there. So we are going to talk about past perfect. So Sriram, listen carefully. We were discussing the past continuous, the usages of the past continuous here today, right? So where, when, and what situation we are using past continuous? Sriram, can you tell me?
Yes, ma'am.
Past continuous is used in which all situations? Usage of past continuous. That is over. Not even listened. Pranavatmak. Pranavatmak.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Past continuous. I have discussed a few usages of past continuous now. Okay. Tell me, can you tell me, Pranavatmak?
Then two actions.
Two actions?
One is in the past.
It's not clear for me. Two past actions.
And two actions.
It's not clear. Tanmay? Tanmay?
Yes, ma'am.
Can you tell me in which place we are using past continuous tense? Just to discuss.
When two actions happen at the same...
Before the two actions, we discussed simply the rule, just the usages of simple past tense. Sorry, past continuous tense. What was it? Past continuous is used to indicate an action which was going on at the point of time or over a period of time in the past, which was going on. That going on or happening is very important. Very, very important, because it was happening. I was reading a novel, right? It was going on at 5 o'clock this morning. I was reading, or I was studying, or I was doing my homework. At 5 o'clock, at 5 a.m. today, this morning, I was completing my homework. Now the time is 11:45, isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
Isn't it? To show a continuous action happening in the past. Okay? No. We are using past continuous tense. Not only that, if two actions are happening at the same time, two parallel actions are happening at the same time in the past, for showing that also we are using past continuous tense. We discussed about I was studying while Emelina was watching TV. I was studying while Carolyn Matthew was dancing. Okay. So this is the two parallel actions. Here I am preparing the food. I am looking at the dining room. I can see that Delvin is playing, reading Balarama, keeping inside the grammar book. Right? I am cooking the lunch for you now. And I can see that there is a Balarama inside the book and he is reading it. See? Did he doing that? No, it's a plain book. So you haven't written anything today. It's a plain book. Fine. Oh, very good, very good. When two actions only up to there. Fine. So listen carefully. So we are at the same two actions, if it is going on, if it is parallel action. See, I was preparing the lunch. Okay, this time, 10 o'clock, I was preparing lunch. Then I can see that Nelvin, at the same time, Nelvin was completing his notes. Okay, two parallel actions. And we are using this past continuous out of two action is an ongoing action. Okay, if you want to stress on an ongoing action happened in the past tense, or it is going on at the past tense, we are using past continuous. Okay?
Okay,
kids? Oh, I have given an example also. What was the example I said?
I was watching TV when
they were sleeping.
The light went off. Another one more example. The light went out while I was reading. The light went out while I was reading. So went out, two actions. One is completed, the other one was going on. To show an ongoing action, I can use past continuous there. Clear?
Yes, ma'am. Let us discuss
about past perfect today. Do you know there is a meaning for past perfect? Do you know the meaning?
Answer, ma'am.
The word meaning past perfect. Yes, Amna Shirlin.
Ma'am, have you uploaded the notes in the website?
Usages I haven't. After completing this class, only I'll be uploading the usages. Okay? Usages okay, I haven't uploaded because I want to, if you are getting the notes prior to my class, you are all thorough with the notes and you will be not allowing me to discuss with you. Okay? Because you will come after preparation. I don't want you to be prepared before my class. That is why I haven't uploaded. Okay? Okay, so past perfect. What is the word meaning of past perfect? Past perfect means?
Ready an action took place.
Something that happened before something else.
Does it, Issa?
The action that is
already. Issa, something you said. What is it, Issa? Issa Jeevaraj.
Ma'am, something that happened before something else has happened.
That is very correct. The usage is very correct. So past perfect means past of the past. Okay, not down. Past of the past. Two actions.
Some point of past.
Past.
Time earlier before.
Just not down. Past perfect means past of the past. I'll show you with the help of an example. I will show you how to use past perfect. Look at here. Past perfect is me, or it means past of the past. Past of the past.
Past
of the past. So I'm going to write a sentence here. The sentence is, when I reached the station, please write, when I reached the station, okay, when I reached the station, comma, the train had left. Okay, when I reached the station, the train had left. Look at the two pieces. If you break it into two pieces, look at the two sentences. I reached the station. It is already over, isn't it? It is in past tense. It is in past tense. It is in simple past tense, isn't it? And look at the second one.
Yes, ma'am.
The train had left. It is also in past. Okay? This has also happened in the past tense. It has happened already over. It is a completed action. So two actions that also completed. Okay, to show past of the past. What do you mean by past of the past? Out of this action, one past action happened earlier than the other one.
One action.
Okay? Out of two actions, one action happened earlier than the other one. One earlier action and a later action. So I'll write like this, earlier action. Just note down, earlier action. Okay, one action happened earlier than the other one. Earlier action and later action. Two actions. Both the actions are already happened. Okay? Both the actions are already happened. There is no doubt. Both the sentences, look at here, reached simple past form and had left past perfect form. So here, the hint. Here, you are getting the hint here. We are using past perfect to show past of the past. That is an earlier action.
Later action.
Earlier action. Completed?
Yes, ma'am.
Shall I stop sharing?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So out of these two actions, one is happen earlier than the second one. So the first action must be in past perfect tense. okay, the earlier action must be in or must be indicated using past perfect tense. Two actions, both the actions are used in past tense, or both the actions are in past tense. One is earlier action, the other one is later action. So out of this, the earlier action, when you write, you must use past perfect tense. Okay, the later action you have to use simple past. Okay, clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Clear, children? Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Where or when or at what situation we are using past perfect tense? Past perfect tense is used to show the earlier action.
Later action.
And the later action.
And later action.
Okay, so I have to give you one statement. All of you, please note it down. If two actions occurred in the past, just note down, if two actions occurred in the past, in the bracket, one past action earlier than the other past action. One past action earlier than the other past action. Close the bracket, comma. The past perfect is used for.
Can you repeat?
The past perfect is used for.
Open the bracket, right?
Not in the bracket. You have to close after past action, then put a comma. The past perfect is used for earlier past action. Look at the board. Look at the example. Which one is the earlier past action? Here. Which one is the earlier past action? Two actions.
Had left.
The train had left. So right, the train had left in the bracket. The train had left in the bracket.
Reached.
Earlier past action, and open a bracket and write, the train had left. Close bracket. And the simple past, and the simple past.
Now can you repeat?
For the later past action, and the simple past for the, and the simple past for the later past action. Which is the later past action out of this two? Second one.
Reached.
So write in the bracket, I reached. So you have got a past of the past year. So tell me, which is past of the past used in the sentence?
Had left.
The train had left, because that is the first action. The train had left is the earlier past action. And I reached is the later past action. Out of two past actions, the earlier one must be used in past perfect, and the later past action must be used in simple past.
Simple past.
Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Is the concept clear?
Yes, ma'am.
So, not down. Past perfect means, a short not, past perfect means, past of the past. Past perfect means past of the past. Okay, past of the past. Clear? Now past perfect is clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you have any doubts?
No, ma'am.
Okay, so one more example. The thieves had run away before the police arrived.
Thieves
The thief, T-H-I-E-V-E-S, plural. T-H-I-E-V-E-S, I am, you made a mistake. What is the spelling? Thieves.
T-H-I-E-S.
T-H-I-E-V-E-S. Had run away, had run away before the police arrived. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, and the last one under the past tense, past perfect continuous. Okay, past continuous is over, past perfect is over, and now we are going to discuss past perfect continuous. When or what or how to use past perfect continuous in English grammar?
Action is still
past
going.
Action which is still going on.
It was began in some time at the,
in
past,
the past
and it
still
was
continuing.
Going on
is
for a, for a particular time. It was happening. It was going on for a particular time in the past. To show such an action, we are using past perfect continuous. I'll show you the slide. Children, listen. Past perfect continuous. Okay? Past perfect continuous. The past perfect tense is used to indicate that action was going on in the past when a second one took place. Okay, it was used to indicate that an action was going on in the past when a second one took place. This is actually in the case of two actions. Okay, if we are not mentioning two actions, normally we are using past perfect continuous tense to indicate an action was completed. Sorry, which was began in the past and also continued up to a point of time in the past. Okay, this one is actually, we are comparing with the two actions, but normally we are using past perfect continuous to describe an action which began at some or in the point of time in the past and is continued up to certain point of time in the past. Okay, up to, it was going on in the point of time and up to a point of time, until a point of time in the past. Okay, look at the part, the examples. When Mr. Smith came to the school in 2018, Mr. Anand had already been teaching there for 5 years. So two actions, look at the examples. When Mr. Smith came to the school in 2018, okay, Mr. Anand had already been teaching there for 5 years. Okay, two actions. Smith came. When he came, he met Mr. Anand. He had been teaching there for 5 years. Okay. Okay.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
They had been talking for over an hour before Tommy arrived. Look at the second sentence. They had been talking for over an hour before Tommy arrived. Look at here, two actions. Tommy arrived. The time, what he can see there. He met his friends, were talking. He met his friends there. They had been talking for over an hour. Okay. Okay. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Clear?
Yes,
so ma'am. Past tense is over by today. The usages of all the past and simple past is over. Past continuous is over. Past perfect is over. Important. Past perfect is very important. So please remember past of the past. Okay. Okay. And past perfect continuous is over. Yeah. So we'll be taking future and its usages in the coming days. Thank you. See you.
Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much. See you in the next class.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bye, ma'am.